Hello, and welcome to episode 7 of C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. Once a week, I'll pick some topic of interest in C++ and dig into it with some live coding. In this episode, I'm going to explain to you and show you why you should stop using std end line. I often still see example code like this. This is a simple hello world. We will say hello world end line from well-meaning people and people who know what they're doing. And this works just fine. We get hello world. Now the problem is an understanding of what exactly std end line does. It turns out, and I only learned this a few years ago myself, that std end line is actually the equivalent of doing a new line character followed by a flush. You get exactly the same results here. The problem is, do you really need to be doing a flush? I'm guessing you don't. So I want to illustrate this with a quick test of some performance characteristics. We're going to create a new file, ofstream out file output.txt, and we want to do iOS base trunk. We want it to be starting with a new file each time we run this test, just so that we don't have a file that's growing out of control. Let's write a quick function that simply writes a line to an IO stream. So write line const std string and we want it to be going to an O stream reference. All right. OStream, str, std, endline. We'll start with the endline example first. So let's say we want to write, 100,000 lines out. We need something that's going to be big enough that it's going to give us some performance characteristics to actually compare. Write line, hello world. To out file. That should compile. No, it didn't. Oh, forgot my namespace qualifier. No stream. There we go. All right, so that wrote what we would expect it to this output.txt. It's still not writing quite enough data for us to actually get any kind of meaningful timing measurement out of it. Okay, we're going to compile with optimizations this time. So that takes approximately 1.71 seconds. In the example case where we are sending std endline. So let's instead do a new line character and now it takes 0.1 seconds to do the exact same thing. That's clearly a significant performance improvement. Now, a little note here, this is something that I noticed in some example code from Bjarne Strustrup, is that really, instead of sending a string, we should be sending a single character. And this should be more efficient, although it's not something that you would ever really, I think, should ever really come up timing-wise. But you are asking the stream operator to do something very different. If you send it a string like this, it's going to have to loop over all the characters in the string looking for null and then stop when it's done. But if you send it a single character, it knows that it has exactly one thing to do. It needs to write that character to the output. So it's interestingly, it's almost exactly the same. We notice maybe slightly less memory usage because of the single character instead of the string version. Let's see, that's 13k for the single character version for the compiled file size. And it's actually a significantly smaller program if we send it the full string version. But I still say you should prefer to just, if you're sending a character, send a character. All right, so to get back to the point of this episode, we are looking at a difference of 1.7 seconds versus 0.1 seconds for end line versus not sending an end line. The problem is that when you're sending something to the file system and you're sending flush, you're actually asking the operating system to do something specific. You're asking it to flush all of the output of the file into the actual file on disk. And there's absolutely no reason to do that in this case. Like, if you really, really cared to make sure that the file was flushed, you could do it once at the very end, for example. And yeah, we still get basically the exact same timing. Where this comes up in code that I've seen is I've been working on code that generated very much output. So it would be like write file output, and it would take an O stream, just like this. And then it would dump, say, hundreds of lines that were like this. And what we ended up with was code where we ended up in this crazy situation that was unexpected and took me personally a while to figure out what was going on, where if you did the obvious thing and said out file and said write file output to out file versus string stream write file output ss and then out file ss dot write. So this version with simply writing to the output file was something like 100 times slower, well, at least 10 times slower, at least an order of magnitude slower than writing it to a string stream first. And this is just not the kind of behavior that you would expect to have, because you're using presumably significantly more memory in the string stream version because you're having to construct the entire string in memory first. And besides the fact that you're also increasing your compile time a whole lot by having to instantiate all of these left stream operators, when instead you could have just incorporated your new line into the string itself. So you get a smaller compile size faster compile time, faster run time, unless you absolutely, positively need to flush the string on every output. So thanks for listening to this episode, and as always, let me know if you have any comments about my setup. You can find me on Twitter. You can find me on my website, emptycrate.com. Thanks.